Good morning. It's 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. It's Saturday morning, and you know what that means. It's time for Saturday Morning Cereals. This is your captain speaking, and I want you guys to get your bowl of cereal. I want you to get your Pop-Tarts. I want you to get your cup of coffee, cups of orange juice, glass of milk. And I want you to sit back, because we're going old school today. Okay, we're going back. There is not one cartoon in this initial eight. I'm not gonna lie, I will put a newer cartoon past the credits. We're gonna try that one out. This is gonna be our test cartoon, your bonus cartoon. But your first eight cartoons are 70s, 80s, that's it. No 90s, no 2000s. 70s, late 70s, early 80s, that's it. So, before we get too far, remember, Saturday Morning Cereals is brought to you every week by RU Game, the best comic book, collectible, toy, video game, magic, movies. I even got Laserdiscs. Laserdiscs. If you dig into the case, I have VHS tapes, but I got beta Star Trek episodes. Original Star Trek on beta. That's what you need. So, yeah. So, RU Game is bringing you this again. But here we go, guys. This first eight. All old school Saturday morning stuff. Some stuff I haven't aired in forever. Not some stuff I aired once, maybe twice, whatever. But I'm going back. So, if you guys don't like this old throwback episode, let me know. Let me know below. Tell me what's going on. Okay. And before I get too far, I need to let everybody know. I cannot air episodes of Pirates of Darkwater. I cannot air SWAT Cats. I cannot air Thundar the Barbarian. And as of recently, it doesn't look like you can air Alvin and the Chipmunks, the TV series, because it looks like they took that down. So, that's where we're at currently. So, I'm always looking for cartoons to air. And that's why I do the episode, the end of the episode, and I tack that bonus episode on post-credits. Because that's the test episode. So, here you guys go. I'm bringing back an old one, one I haven't aired for a while. We're doing Rubik the Amazing Cube. That's right. Rubik. Voiced by Howie Mandel, I believe. Weird concept, man. Seriously. I've said this once, I'll say it a thousand times. Magically powered Rubik's Cube. Weird concept. Here you guys go. This is Rubik the Amazing Cube, and this is Rubik and the Buried Treasure. Enjoy.
This is the greatest, fishing on a Saturday morning.
Yeah, Cherokee, you like yours.
You think it's okay, Ronaldo?
Yeah, I don't see anyone around.
Ah, Rubik feels good now. That was hot.
Sorry, Rubik. Just gotta be careful no one spots you.
One thing's for sure. The fish never will. I don't think there's any fish in this ocean.
Rubik, get fish.
Nice catch, Rubik.
Oh, no.
Swim over here, to the side.
Come on, you can do it.
Yeah, we'll grab you.
Look, it looks like it.
we should throw this one back?
Nah, add it to our collection.
That was a lucky break for us hearing about the map just before we got out of prison.
Yeah, a map to smuggler's loot, and it's gonna be all ours. As soon as we get the map out of this thing.
Well, let me see it. I knew it. It's buried on this island, not too far from here.
It's a whopper!
But what about the curse that's supposed to be on the loot, Harry?
It's just a stupid superstition.
It's a curse! I told you, it's a curse!
I don't get it. Maybe it was the wind. Whatever. It had to go somewhere, and we're gonna get it back. Come on.
What happened? You okay?
Rubik, sorry. Got carried away.
That looks like a treasure map on your chest.
And look, there's an X that marks the spot.
Yeah, just like in the book, Treasure Island.
Rubik must have zapped it out of somebody's hands. But who?
Hey, our map! That kid's wearing our map.
How'd he get it?
Don't ask questions. Let's just get it back.
Rubik, no trouble.
Uh-huh. And it looks like it's coming this way.
Which means we should go this way, pronto.
Can't let him get away.
Faster. These guys mean business.
Rubik, stop.
Let's help, Rubik.
What's going on here?
Rubik, let's go. Follow him.
Those kids.
Come on.
Those creeps don't take hits very well, do they?
Rubik, special. Coming up.
What's going on?
May the curse, Harry! Get out of here, you mutt!
Oh, no!
Sparky, come on!
Rubik!
There goes our map!
Where'd they go? They were here a minute ago!
I don't know. We lost them! Come on! We've got some figuring to do.
I am one worried little girl. They're up to something. Maybe we should go to the police.
Sure, and we'll just show them the map in her chest, then tell them how it got there.
Lisa's got a point. Let's take Rubik and look into this. Maybe we can get more evidence.
I just don't understand how those kids did it.
Maybe they're magicians.
We're not giving up. That map showed exactly where the treasure was buried.
You two have to do something.
Hey, just try to be helpful.
What's that?
It's those kids.
Get them.
Uh-oh, they see us.
Well, we're not afraid. We've got Rubik.
Got a plan. Let's hide under that inflatable raft.
Forget your plan, Lisa. Let's go.
Faster, faster.
How about in here?
No, it's too dangerous.
It's more dangerous out there with those crooks.
Carlos, right, Lisa. It's dangerous here.
Yeah, come on. Hurry!
Oh no! Rubik!
Get the kid with the map!
Let me go! Pick on someone your own size! Or bigger!
Looks like you got something of us!
Okay, a nice little party. Now, let's all go on a treasure hunt.
Hey, what about the pooch?
Here, lock him in with the kids.
You better let us go right now.
You're kidding.
I'm serious.
Shh, Lisa, we've got Rubik, remember?
Yeah, we got connections.
Hurry up with Rubik, Carlos.
Another sec.
What's this?
You leave that alone. I mean it. That's my brother.
Well, he won't be needing his toys where we're going.
Oh, my gosh!
You're the one we want. The others can stay here.
Listen, how about we make a deal, huh?
No deals. Now, we got a treasure to steal.
Rook!
Boy, are we in a fix. If we ever needed Rubik, we need him now. Took him. They're going after the treasure.
Those men, not good. Tell me about it. We go find them.
Way to go, Rubik. Okay, Rubik, set the course for Carlos.
Keep digging. This has to be the spot.
I hope you're right. Hey, I hit something. Harry, it's the chest.
Well, bring it up. Well, kid, we've got what we wanted.
And we won't be needing you anymore.
Okay, Rubik, you got your work cut out for you now.
No problem. For Rubik.
What's happening?
I'm telling you, it's a curse. It's a curse.
It's no curse. It's just the wind.
Good old Rubik.
Vamonos. Let's go. Hey, hermano Pequito.
I knew Rubik wouldn't let me down. Come on, quick.
Yeah! See? No curse. Just those meddling kids. Now, let's beat it.
Right behind you.
Oh, no. Talk about a bad day. Rubik must help kids.
I don't think Sparky's going to be able to dig us out in time.
Dig, Sparky, dig.
Rubik's in that gator.
I never thought I'd be happy to see a big alligator with its mouth open.
Oh, Rubik did it again.
Rubik do good.
Good?
Even that devil map finally came off Carlo's shirt. Thanks, Rubik.
Yeah, but we've still got to settle with those crooks. You think maybe it's time for a magic carpet ride?
Gotcha!
And we'll beat those guys back to the boat.
A little more this way.
Now we'll have to tie it together.
Nice!
Great work! Come on, let's give it a whirl.
To the other side of the island. Full steam ahead! Hold on tight!
You see up here, Lisa? There they are! Set her down, Rubik! I got a plan!
Okay! So what you got planned, Carlo?
They think there's a curse on the treasure. So that's what they're gonna get.
What do you say we open it and see how rich we are?
Yeah! Sounds like a great idea! Kids again! After them!
Uh-oh! So much for the plan, Carlos!
What are we waiting for? It's Vamanos time!
That way! They're heading for the shack! Move it!
This is almost too easy!
Yeah, what could go wrong?
For starters, the door's locked. We can't go in, but... we can go under.
Oh, wow, look!
Rubik made everything giant.
Look again, Lisa. Rubik made us tiny.
Come on!
Hurry up and flatten yourself, Rubik, so you can slide under.
Rubik, right behind.
He must be inside the shack.
Uh-oh, bad men coming. Can't let him see me. Where's Rubik?
What's this? It looks like those kids' toy. They must be inside the shack.
No way! The door was locked!
They've got Rubik!
Let's go help Rubik!
Gotta get Rubik.
They're not even in here.
It's them.
Those creeps and the pelican? Either way, we've had it.
So I was wrong. I just like to play it careful.
Me too. Hold on tight, guys.
Let's get back to our treasure.
Oh, they're gone.
But that bird isn't.
We gotta find Rubik.
It's Rubik, but he's misaligned.
Shh. Over there. You're safe now.
Oh, no. How second snack.
Shh. Here's our way, guys. Follow me.
Thank you. Rubik needed that.
Anytime, Rubik.
Now let's get back to those guys.
We're rich!
I am the curse of the treasure!
I heard it that time! This treasure is cursed!
Leave the treasure! Now! I said, leave! You are cursed forever!
Please don't hurt me! Please!
The kite! It is for real!
Now, the treasure is yours! What the...
And we can get back to the pier and the fish.
But first, we have to get the police over here to pick them up.
Rubik can do, with help of friends.
No!
Hey, Captain, look what we have here.
Well, well, looks like a couple of crooks and a stolen treasure.
Not taken care of.
Wow!
Rubik, for a cube, you're too much. Okay, back to pier and fish.
Sure, but how?
Hold arms out.
Do what?
You see?
Go! Whee! This is the neatest!
Rebels won't tire till they see the last of the Empire, and Kenner's there with Star Wars Return of the Jedi collection.
It's Ewok Village. I must save my friends.
Then that's set.
Dear me.
It's C-3PO, Lugray, and Ewok Village playset. Action figures, each sold separately. You have to put it together.
Your throne, O Golden King, will celebrate with special stew, a barbecue.
No celebration for me until my friends are free.
Ewok Village playset from Star Wars Return of the Jedi collection. Action figures sold separately from Kenner.
To my house.
I'll bring my guys. You have yours.
I've got Junkyard Dog.
It's World Wrestling Federation Superstars.
I've got Brutus Beefcake.
Here's George the Animal Steel.
I've got Great Hammer Valentine.
Ricky the Dragon Steel.
Yeah! They're so real.
And Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Can you tell the difference?
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Wrestling superstars, they're for real. Each sold separately from LJN.
Yeah!
I hope you like Rubik the Amazing Cube. And, who remembers this? I know, people are going to freak out because of the form of comic book, because of the beat-up issue of ROM. But look at that. Who remembers when they would put these in comic books? What was coming Saturdays? The new cartoons, man. Dungeons & Dragons, CBS Story Break, Charlie Brown and Snoopy, the Berenstain Bears, the Wuzzles, Young Astronauts, Rock and Roll, Hulk Hogan's Rock and Wrestling, and Jim Henson, Muppet Baby and Monsters, starts Saturday, September 14th, only on CBS. So, but I'm not CBS, but you've seen some of these cartoons from me. So, yeah. All right, here we go. We're going back. This one's 70s, I think 78, 79. So, we're going Fangface. Fangface. Yet again, the whole Scooby-Doo aspect to this show. But this one's Ruby Spears. And a lot of these are Ruby Spears. Rubik was Ruby Spears. Fangface was Ruby Spears. Some of these other ones on here, Ruby Spears. Man, it's just a damn shame, man. They folded into Hanna-Barbera. Then Hanna-Barbera folded into Warner Brothers. So, you know, I guess it's a thing. But here you guys go. This is Fangface, Episode 7. And this is... Don't Abra when you can Kadabra. Yeah, that's easy for me to say. Don't Abra when you Kadabra. Enjoy.
Fangface! Every 400 years, a baby werewolf is born into the Fangsworth family. And so, when the moon shined on little Sherman Fangsworth, he changed into Fangface! The werewolf! Only the sun can change him back to normal. And so Little Fangs grew up and teamed up with three daring teenagers, Kim, Biff, and Pugsy. And together they find danger, excitement, and adventure. Save the day! Who can wrong the rights and right the wrongs? None other than Fangface!
The shipment of scientific equipment, Miss Stowe.
Excellent. Now to capture it. With the boxcar's electronic equipment in my hands, the world will soon see Super Mr. Magic that will bring them to my feet.
I gotta concentrate on beating Pudsey's score of 10 million.
Fat chance!
And I'm gonna do it in one shot! Tough luck, Pugs! You lose!
Yeah, shut up. You cheated and you lose.
Oh, yeah? Uncle Arnie will settle it. Uncle Arnie! Uncle Arnie!
Shh! There's a special news report on!
Police are still investigating the mystery of the missing boxcar, containing the world's most modern electronic equipment, which magically vanished into the sky over Shark Beach.
Huh? How can a boxcar vanish into thin air? Huh? How could it? Huh? How?
Good question, Fangs. Come on, gang. We're going to Shark Beach and find out.
This is the spot where the boxcar vanished.
Yeah, and there ain't no sign of nothing nowhere.
Except that old decrepitated beach house up ahead. Maybe whoever habitated saw the train disappear.
Right. Come on, let's ask him.
Well, blimey and shiver me timbers, visitors, come in, come in.
Ooh, ooh, look at all them fish.
My sweet little lovelies, my precious pets.
Sorry to bother you, but we were wondering if you saw the train that disappeared.
Oh, I bet I did, mateys. Yes, sirree. That chopper lifted the boxcar up and poof, it vanished.
Ooh! Ooh!
Then the chopper sailed out to sea, heading straight out past the old lighthouse toward Shark Island.
Ooh! Ooh! The moon! I feel fun!
Uh-oh! Fang saw the moon and changed to Fangface.
There he is!
This time I got you!
Oh no, Fangface! That's Pugs, your pal!
Oh, oh! So it is! So it is! Sorry, Pug. You look awful ugly. But I love you anyway.
Next stop, Shark Island. There it is.
Willikers. No wonder they call it Shark Island. It looks like a giant shark's fin.
Yeah, and whomever lives in that weirdo castle may be the weirdo behind this mystery. Yikes! The door opened all by its lonesome.
Golly, this place looks like a bad set in a bad movie.
Yeah, it's the creepiest of all the creepy places we ever creeped into.
Where's the creep that lives here? Where is he?
You have dared enter the castle of Misto, the world's greatest magician, and for that, you shall pay dearly.
Oh, yeah? Say who?
Say who? Oh, yeah!
Duck!
Oh, my gosh! He's trying to make us disappear!
Oh, yeah? Well, it's him who's gonna disappear! Gotcha. Well, you won't get away from me. Why, you step, you
step. That magical creepo's disappeared.
Yeah, but where?
Here.
It's him. Come on, let's get him.
Ooh, how'd he do that?
Who cares? We gotta get Biff and Kim out of this box.
No problem, Pugs. See, Pugs? No problem.
An hippopotamus is a tiger.
Run! Yeah, run!
I'll open that closet door. You get the tiger inside.
Gotcha!
To say olay! Olay!
Oh! Olay! That's what I said! Olay! Olay, El Tigero!
Congratulations. Now we gotta configure how to make Biff and Kim reappear.
Yeah, yeah. But how?
We gotta find that Mr. Frying Misto and learn the secret of that magical box. Misto's gotta be around here somewheres.
Yeah. But where is somewhere?
Listen, it's an electronic hum coming from down below.
Ooh, ooh, look!
With the electronic equipment we stole from the boxcar and the secrets of my book of magic, I shall soon finish my super wand. And with its power, I shall bend and twist the skyscrapers of New York until the city is mine! Mine!
Ha 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 ha! Yikes! He's gonna make a corkscrew out of New York City!
Oh yeah? I'll make a corkscrew out of him!
Hold it. First, we gotta save Biff and Kim. That magical book should have the secret to the trick box. And that magician's dummy down there gives me an idea how we can learn it. Cause he looks just like another dummy I know.
Ooh, ooh, yeah! Who pugs? Who, huh?
Never mind. Just look at this picture of the sun.
Huh? Hey, where am I, huh?
Quiet, Pinhead. You gotta dress in that other dummy suit, and then you gotta... Get moving, meathead!
Ooh, ooh, okay, okay! Ooh, ooh! I'll never remember all them secret words! I'd better get a pencil and write down the instructions!
What was that?
It's that dummy, Misto.
Hi! Ooh, ooh!
Run, you dummy! Yikes! We can't move!
Ooh, ooh, you're right, Pugs!
See what you did, you dummy? You got us both trapified!
Fools! You will never escape! We can forget the intruders now. My super wand is almost completed, and soon we will take it to New York and demonstrate its powers!
Shut up. There's only one thing to do, and that's because I ain't got no other choice. Here, look at this picture of the moon.
I got you this time for sure. Gotcha.
Okay, you gotcha me. Now get your ass out of this trunk. We gotta save Biff and Kim.
Ooh, sure, Punk, sure. Why'd you say so, huh? Why?
Let's go. Back to the magical box. Okay, Fangface, use the magical words you learned from Misto's magical book and make Biff and Kim reappear.
Huh? What words? What book?
Yikes. He can't remember what he read when he was Fangs. I'll have to use my trusty picture of the sun and... Oh, no. I must have lost it inside the trunk. I'll have to hypnotize you and probe your subconsciousness memory. If you got one.
Yeah, if I got one.
Huh? Here, concentrate on his swinging yo-yo.
Ooh, ooh. Ooh, ooh. Oh.
Search deep in your memorizer. You gotta re-memorize how to save Biff and Kim.
Oh.
Think!
Abracadabra, and presto, smasto. Down with side one. Down with side two. Down with side three. Down with side four. And there you have it. Ta-da! It's still empty. Ooh, ooh, I forgot. Up with trapdoor five.
Golly, we didn't think you'd ever figure out how to get us out of here.
Now that you're free, we gotta stop that creep Misto from discombobulating New York City.
Listen, what's that?
It sounds like a helichopper.
Willikers, it's Misto!
And he's taking off in his helicopter.
With his super wand strapified to it.
Come on, gang. I've got a plan that may stop him.
Everything is ready, Misto.
Excellent. They shall soon see the incredible power of my super wand, Kazam Adabra. Ha ha!
Oh. It's incredible.
He's bending the buildings as if they're rubber.
Leaping ignoramuses. Misto's wand is rectifying the whole city.
And he's heading straight for the Statue of Liberty.
We've got to get there first and cut him off.
Yeah! Cut him off at the statue!
Now here's how we get Misto's wand. Fangface climbs up to Miss Liberty's torch with a grappling hook. Pugsy will tie the rope to one of the spikes on her head.
I get you. Soon as Misto's in range, Fangface tosses the grappling hook at his wand.
And I'll yank it loose.
Right. Then we'll re-rig it to capture Misto with some of our magic.
Here he comes!
Okay. Wait till he gets in range and then let him have it.
Willikers, Misto stopped.
And he's too far away for Fangface to throw the grappling hook.
Now, for the greatest trick of my career, I shall saw the Statue of Liberty in half.
Ooh, ooh. We're supposed to get him, and he's got us.
Yikes! We just become part of one of Misto's magical tricks.
Now for the sawing. Abracazabra, presto!
Ooh, ooh, I hope she isn't ticklish.
Wow. It's unbelievable.
I can't believe it.
Oh. He's sawing the Statue of Liberty in half.
What do we do, Biff?
Well, there's nothing we can do. From here on, it's up to Pugsy and Fangface.
Hey! That was a pretty good trick, huh, Pugs?
Yeah, good for nothing.
Fools! Now that they've seen my power, they will obey my every command. Enough! Replace the statue!
Quick, Fangface! Toss the grappling hook!
Yeah!
Bullseye!
We got it!
Yeah!
Well, we had it!
Oh, quick, climb up that rope! We gotta get on that magic wand and control it! Okay, Fangface, as soon as I get that wand rewired so we can fly it, you cut it loose.
Gotcha!
Give me the tools.
Look, Pugsy's rewiring Misto's magic wand.
All set. Rip it loose. I'll operate the controls.
Ooh, ooh. What's going wrong?
Hold on, hold on! I'll figure out how to fly this thing any second!
Misto, look, behind us!
They have my super wand! We must escape!
catch him!
Yeah, shut up! I'm flying this thing!
Shut up! I'll show you how to fly this thing!
Excellent! We've lost them!
There, Pug! I got him! Just like I said!
Yeah, you got him! And I'm glad you still got me!
Well, the city's back to normal.
And Misto's magic won't help him get out of jail.
Hey, I've got a big punk score of 10 million with my last ball. Cheat! Cheat! The flipper busted! Ooh. I got a million for lighting up the sun! Hey, where am I, huh? Hey, 20 million? I won! I beat Pug!
Yes, sir, pal, you won. You really won. You won yourself 2 weeks' work fixing that machine.
Ooh, ooh, Pugs, next time do me a favor.
What's that?
Next time, remind me to lose.
Sea dives of Deep Rover. Recently, scientists have been exploring the depths of California's Monterey Canyon in a new type of submarine. We'll be back with some of their underwater discoveries in the news.
Here are a few words about Levi's jeans and cords.
Levi's.
Cats and dogs, and
another
news
time officials.
And now, Deep Rover, down in the depths, in the news. Deep Rover is a new type of submarine. It dives more than 2,000 feet below the ocean's surface. But what makes it special is that it can go just about anywhere the pilot wants. Unlike other deep-diving craft, it is not tied or attached to ships on the surface. This freedom has opened up a new world for underwater explorers. Here, off the coast of California, they dive into an undersea canyon larger than Arizona's Grand Canyon. What they've seen and photographed has amazed even experts. An eel pout that protects itself by coiling up to try to look like a type of jellyfish that other fish wouldn't want to eat. Siphonophores, colonies of animals divided up so that some parts are responsible for food while others are in charge of protection. And a narcomedusa, a jellyfish that has its own lighting system called bioluminescence. That's not unusual down here, where the sun's light never reaches. 80% of the animals here generate their own light. Occasionally, when scientists want to capture one of these rare animals for further study, they just suck it up with Deep Rover's slurp gun. It doesn't hurt the creature. These deep dives have changed scientists' view of the number of animals living in the ocean and opened new possibilities for feeding mankind with life from the sea. I'm Christopher Glenn with the discoveries of Deep Rover in the news.
how many of you people, sorry about that. How many of you sent away for the glow-in-the-dark shoestrings and poster? Posters, because you got three posters for $3, man. If you sent it from Neon Laces. That'd be really cool. Anybody still got those? That's what I want to know. If you still got those and you want to get rid of them, let me know. Because that'd be kind of cool to have. So, alright. I hope you liked Fangface. Like I said, it's all late 70s, early 80s cartoons. Boom. Classic Saturday morning. We're going to keep it going. And we're bringing you Goldie Gold in Action Jack. And the best part about Goldie Gold in Action Jack is one of the people who is doing the character designs, none other than Jack the King Kirby. That's right. Jack Kirby worked on this. He worked on a lot of cartoons. He worked on one of my favorite cartoons of all time, Thundar the Barbarian, if you couldn't tell. So, here you guys go. This is Goldie Gold and Action Jack, and it's the Red Rust of Doom. Enjoy.
Goldie Gold, the world's richest girl. And Action Jack, daredevil reporter for Goldie's newspaper, the Gold Street Journal. By sea, by the seat of their pants, they travel the world in search of adventure. Goldie Gold and Action Jack.
Rembatan Embassy, next stop. I guess I need to practice my landings.
You asked for an exciting evening, Mr. Ambassador.
And I got one. Thank you, Goldie and Jack. Good night.
You're late, Mr. Ambassador.
Huh? Who are you? What do you want?
Call me the Grey Marauder. My little pet has placed you completely under my control.
Yes.
Get me the secret itinerary of the King of Lombata now!
Portrait of the King of Rambata. It must have come from the ambassador's window.
The 340 train. I'll seize the king from his private car, and with his help, I'll soon be the richest man on earth. You may go now, out on the ledge.
Yes.
Maybe it's a Rambatan custom to throw gifts out the window.
Goldie, look!
The ambassador! He's going to jump!
Oh, no, he's not! Hang on!
Ambassador! No, stop!
Get him, Goldie! Struck out, huh?
Jack, watch out! You could have flown around it, you know.
There he goes.
Ambassador, are you all right?
Oh, my gosh. Look.
Yuck, it's horrible.
340. My king. My king.
What does that mean?
You got me. But I know who can tell us what this means. Dr. Nat Crawley, the world-famous entomologist.
It's called Insectus hypnotus. Extremely rare, found only in the bogs of New Guinea.
But what did it do to the ambassador, Dr. Crawley?
It may have placed him under the control of another person.
The king! He's in danger! The Gray Marauder is going to attack him on the 340 train!
The Gray Marauder?
It's 3:15 already!
Go! There's no time to lose. I'll be fine.
Thanks, Dr. Crawley. Come on! We've got a train to catch.
There! The king's private car! Get me inside! We have business to conduct. You are now under my control. Shall we discuss the red dust mine of Rambata?
There's a train!
And the Gray Marauder beat us to it.
We're not out of the race yet.
Come on!
They've got the king!
Stop them! Use the stun gas!
Can't stand up!
Me either!
Back to my headquarters! The red dust mine of Rambata is within my grasp!
Smash into that mountain!
I know, but I can barely move! Okay, Nugget. Okay. I'll get up.
I think it's wearing off a little. Come on! Try to run!
Faster! Faster!
Goldie! Nugget! Jump! Just what we need, a pug-nosed limo.
Relax. We'll use the spare car. Okay, boys. Where to?
Your private airport. We're taking off to New Guinea.
Right. New Guinea?
Yes. The Gray Marauder's hideout must be there. It's the only place in the world where those insects are found.
But what did he mean about the red dust mine of Rambata?
The Gray Marauder will tell us himself when we get to New Guinea. I guess my hunch was wrong. It's been hours, and there's no sign of a hideout.
We can't give up yet, Jack. It's our only chance.
Nugget's caught a scent. Come on.
You were right, Jack. His hideout is here. Let's get him.
Whoa, Goldie. Slow and easy. We don't know what's inside.
So, Goldie Gold and Jack Travis found their way to my hideout. What a tragedy. For them.
We'll get rid of them.
No, let the fools come inside. My insects will bid them welcome.
This place gives me the creeps.
Do I hear Goldie Gold admitting she's afraid?
I am not afraid.
Now I might be afraid.
As well you should be, Ms. Gold. You are trapped without hope of escape. And my insects shall see to it that you remain in a mindless state for the rest of your lives.
Don't be so sure of that.
Fool! No one can stop me now. I control the red dust mine of Rabata. The nations of the world will pay me billions in blackmail, or they will know the power of the red dust. I leave you to your doom. Farewell!
He'll never get away with it.
I don't know. He's not doing badly so far.
Caviar. I packed emergency rations. It's working.
Maybe there's a secret lever to the door.
Hurry, Jack!
That doesn't give us much time to find an exit.
What do you see?
Our way out. A hole in the ceiling. If only we could get up there.
Let me take care of that.
Make it fast. Feeding time is over.
I'll use my grappling hook.
Ladies first.
I'm almost there.
Good riddance.
But what about the Gray Marauder and this red dust we keep hearing about?
Maybe Sam can help. The Daily Mint has a bureau here in New Guinea. We can call him from there. It does what, Sam?
The red dust of Rambata has the power to turn human flesh into stone. The dust is so dangerous, only the king knows the location of the mine.
Not anymore. The Gray Marauders captured the king.
And if he isn't paid off, he'll petrify the world's population. We've got to stop him.
How? We'll sneak into the country in Goldie's sub.
We can take the Rambata River and meet my old friend, Trader Lou. If anyone would know the location of the mine, he would.
Everything under control, Goldie.
Thanks, Captain. My serve, Jack.
Goldie... Why tennis at a time like this?
We're warming up for the big match with a Gray Marauder.
Either your serve's getting stronger, or we're under attack.
Captain, those are the Gray Marauder's thugs.
Those concussion torpedoes could crack our sub in half.
We can't evade them. We're too big to maneuver in this river.
That does it. I'm going out there.
You're what?
I'm gonna stop those torpedoes.
With a tennis net?
Wish me luck. Semi-hero.
Anyway, the Gray Marauder knows we're here. We better make it to Trader Lou's pronto.
This is Trader Lou's?
Yes.
The trade must be slow these days.
Goldie Gold!
Trader Lou?
Well, son of a gun! What brings you to Rambata?
We have to find the Red Dust Mine. It's urgent.
It's a dangerous place.
So we've heard, but it's important.
Maps of that area are hard to come by. Expensive. But seeing as we're friends, you can have it at a discount. Say, $10 American?
Deal. Jack?
Naturally, the world's richest girl is short on cash. Here you go, Lou.
One map to the Rambata mine.
Let's go, before the dust hits the fan.
Faster! Haul the dust faster!
Yes, faster!
He's got the mine working at full capacity. What do we do?
Follow me. I've got an idea.
Nugget, stay.
Here, slip into this. In these suits, we can get close enough to unbug the king and capture the Gray Marauder.
You two, no loafing. Get that barrel onto the tracks, now!
Yes, now.
This is humiliating. We're not supposed to be helping him.
Get those animals out of here!
Nugget, stay away from the mine! It's dangerous!
Oh, boy. So much for that idea.
Goldie Gold and her friend, seize them!
Hands off, you big bruisers!
I'm warning you guys, Jack Travis is no pushover!
Oh no! The dust! It turned my hand to stone!
Jack! Your hand!
You may join them, Your Majesty! Your usefulness to me is ended!
They even got Nugget!
The reward for your persistence, Miss Gold, is a one-way trip to the bottom of the mine! Miss Gold, enjoy the crash.
Jack, we've got to stop this thing.
Maybe this stone hand will actually come in handy.
How about that? A mine car with a handbrake. Now, if I can just reach my diamond nail clipper... Got it!
Quick, get Nugget out of that sack while I debug the king.
Must stop Gray Marauder. On his way to Miami Beach, he wants $20 billion, or else city by city, he'll turn everyone into stone. Hurry, no known cure for the effects of the red dust.
No cure?
We can worry about that after we stop the Gray Marauder in Miami.
It is time to show the world the power I possess. Release the red dust! Now let us issue our warning to the world. Unless I receive my 20 billion... Attack! Attack!
That's the Gray Marauder, all right.
But we didn't get here in time. Everyone on the beach has turned to stone.
Goldie Gold, alive! Fly toward the city!
He's heading for the city!
Not if we can help it. The autopilot will fly Nugget home. Come on!
They're above, on the balloon, but they won't be there long.
He's trying to shake us.
What do you mean, trying? Enough is enough. The Gray Marauder gave me a weapon, and I'm gonna use it.
Jack!
his thugs are safely trapped inside. Now, let's see who's under the hood. Dr. Crowley!
Yes, and I still have the last laugh. Remember, there is no cure for the red dust.
Jack, my scientists have found something.
We've got it, Jack. We've got the cure.
Give it a shot, Doc. That's 0 for 5.
Oh!
Jack, look! It worked!
It just needed a little whack to get the blood flowing.
Now we can cure the people on Miami Beach.
Terrific. I'll pour and you whack them.
White Schultz, and I'll be right back with One to Grow On.
Where are you going, honey?
Oh, Jerry White and I are going to go play some ball.
Isn't he the new boy down the block?
Uh-huh.
I don't know if I like that boy, Adam.
Oh, Mom.
There's something about him that's different. Maybe you shouldn't play with him.
Hi, Adam. Hi, Mr.
Boy, it can be tough when your parents think differently about one of your friends than you do. But there is a way to solve the problem of choosing between dropping one of your friends and disobeying your parents. Find out what it is that your folks don't like about your friend, and at the same time, assure them that you're not so foolish as to let somebody rope you into trouble. That way they can give your friend a chance and rest easy about you.
I tell you what, Mom, I promise I won't get into any trouble. And Mom, if you get to know Jerry, you'll like him.
Why don't you invite him to dinner next week?
All right, Mom.
And that's One to Grow On.
Ah, too bad. We'll be double trouble for He-Man.
He-Man.
I'll get him. No, he's mine.
Too bad Skeletor and He-Man figures each sold separately.
Too bad.
Well, well, an evil warrior.
Two warriors.
The name's Too Bad.
Too bad for you.
Oh, yeah. Wants me first.
You get him.
No, I'm getting out of here.
Too bad. New from the Masters of the Universe collection. Other action figures, each sold separately. From Mattel.
All right. I hope you like Goldie Gold and Action Jack. One season wonder. Done. I don't know. They love doing that whole Richie Rich, because it was Richie Rich Goldie Gold Hour, and they had to have the rich kids that had the stuff and that could do all the really cool stuff. And yeah. But here we go, guys, check this one out. Yep, that's right, the centerfold. Yeah, for the NBC cartoons, 85-86, Saturday morning, Snorks, Adventures of the Gummy Bears, the Smurfs, Punky Brewster, Alvin and the Chipmunks, Kid Video, Mr. T, Spider-Man and His Amazing Friends, plus One to Grow On. Oh, man. I'll tell you what's funny, because I did not know there's people who love the Snorks and hate the Smurfs, and people who love the Smurfs and hate the Snorks. I don't get that. They were even on the same network. It's not like you had to decide which one you were going to watch. So, all right. Somebody asked for this one. It's one I forgot I hadn't aired in for a while. The Thing. That's right. The Thing. Thing Rings. Do Your Thing. We're bringing you episodes 17 and 18. And this is Out to Launch. And the day Ring didn't do its thing. So, enjoy the weird Fantastic Four-esque cartoon, and yet Scooby-Doo-esque at the same time. So, enjoy.
What's taking Ronald so long?
Ronald, will you hurry up?
We're gonna be late!
Yeah, it's not every day we have a ship launching in this town, and...
What happened, Ronald? Did you get a job as a doorman on a tugboat?
Boy, you'd think they were going to launch him instead of a ship.
Hmm,
A lot, you know. This happens to be what I will wear when I buy that chip.
Buy it? But Ronald, it's already been bought.
It has? Oh, blast. What a bother. That means I have to find something else to spend my allowance on.
Worry about it later. If we don't get to the shipyards, we'll miss the launching ceremony.
Now, Clumply, I will hold you responsible to see that everything goes off smoothly today.
Yes, Mr. Mayor.
After all, this is the first ship to be launched in Centerville's new shipyards. Press will be there, and television cameras, and... Hello, this is your dynamic progressive mayor speaking. What's that?
I said, you will be sorry you are the mayor before I am through. No one fires Manfred von Reckerstein and gets away with it. You will pay dearly for that mistake. You see what I mean, Mr. Mayor?
Who was that?
Just some silly prankster. Nothing to worry.
Ronald Radford, will you come on?
Yeah. Whoever heard of calling for reservations to a ship's launching? We'll sit in the bleachers like everybody else.
Bleachers? Heaven forbid. I intend to use my influence to get us seats on the mayor's platform. That is, if this long-winded fellow ever completes his call. Well, I'm certainly glad you're finished.
Finished? Manfred von Reckerstein, the world's greatest demolition expert, finished? I have not yet begun!
Goodness, what a weirdo. I believe I've been disconnected.
You've been disconnected? The whole phone booth has been disconnected.
Wow, how the heck did that happen?
Practice, practice, practice. And the proper tools, of course. You are impressed with the phone booth? Bah! Child's play. Cast your eyes on that water tower.
Oh, my gosh! The water tank is collapsing.
Yipes! We better get help.
I think that phone is temporarily out of service.
Maybe we can find a policeman. Come on, Benji.
I gotta tie my shoelace.
Oh, brother.
Ring, ring! Do your thing!
Any guy what takes things apart like that von Reckerstein has gotta have a couple of screws loose. Not a play plumber with that overgrown bathtub. Gotcha! Whoops! An umbrella. Or a boat.
Hurry, officers. It's right over here. Do you think I'll get a medal for my quick thinking? After all, the water tower could have...
What water tower? There's nothing here but a big mud hole. A medal, huh? I ought to run you in for wasting my time.
I don't understand. The water tower's disappeared. And where's Benji?
Here I am. Hi.
Wouldn't you know, the first sign of danger and Benji goes underground.
He doesn't know the half of it.
Who in blazes is this Manfred von Reckerstein, Clumply?
Well, he was the head of your wrecking crew until you told me to fire him. He was the best demolition man we ever had. A real expert.
Oh, that's ridiculous. If he was such a genius, why would I fire him?
So we could hire your brother-in-law, Mr. Mayor.
Oh, well,
It's time to leave for the ship's christening, Mr. Mayor. Your limo is waiting.
Ooh, I don't want to be late. I better get dressed. I Must say I've always looked great in formal attire.
I, a Radford, sitting in the bleachers. What if my friends see me?
I wouldn't worry. You don't have any.
That's the kind of remark I expect from my inferior.
Oh, you don't have any of those either. That weirdo is destroying the whole town.
We gotta stop him.
He's getting away.
Not a chance. That rusty heap he's driving can't compare with my car.
And while you're bragging, he's leaving us behind.
Huh. He won't get half a block before we... Whoa!
Stop the car!
I can't. The brakes just fell out.
You better keep your eyes on the road, Ronald.
Oh, really? Well, if you're so smart, why don't you drive? Here. Oh, no. I can't steer.
Oh, no. Look ahead.
My, we're out of gas.
Well, Ronald, your influence got us some really great seats for the ship launching.
Uh-oh. Look what I see.
Good heavens, it's Von Reckerstein.
I bet he's up to no good.
We'd better get over there.
What the? Hey, buddy, get out of the way. You're blocking my view.
Here comes the mayor.
What happened to our shoes?
There they are.
It's all in the wrists.
How do we ever find him in this crowd?
Keep looking. He's got to be around here somewhere.
He's probably miles away by now.
One and a two and a...
Wow, we really have a nut looser on the loose.
And if we don't find him fast, that ship will never get launched.
Look, there he goes.
The ship! That's what he's gonna take apart next!
We better warn the mayor! Too late! The christening's already started!
I christen the SS Seaworthy! This is a disaster!
No, Mr. Mayor. That is not a disaster. This is a disaster!
There he goes!
Let's catch him!
I better get my rings together before the whole shipyard comes apart. Ding, ring, do... Yipes! That guy is as busy as a beaver. Ding, ring, do your... Finally. Thing ring, do your thing.
That ship is sinking and I ain't even in the water yet. It's gonna take more than glue to put this Humpty Dumpty together again. How's about that? Now that's what I call shipshape.
It's Von Reckerstein thing. He's trying to knock down the whole shipyard.
Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. My mother told me to choose this very one. Boy, he ain't playing no kid's game. What a revolting development. Maybe he'll get a rise out of this.
Good work, Thing.
Now that's what I call a magnetic personality.
Gee, Ronald, I still can't believe that you put your car back together all by yourself.
Are you kidding? I'll have you know that I'm an expert mechanic. I've been tutored by only the very best teachers.
I'll bet I know one teacher's name.
Manfred von Reckerstein.
Benji, Kelly, hurry or we'll be late picking up Miss Twilly.
Coming, Ronald. A little more to the left. Now to the right. Uh-oh, watch it. Here comes the Yancey Street gang.
Thanks. I needed that.
Hey, doll, where you going with this bad news boar?
Bad news boar? That's funny, Mike.
Miss Twilly's taking our class on a dig at Badger Cave. We're gonna look for fossils, old bones, and maybe find some Stone Age relics.
Ah, dig. I can dig it.
Hurry, you guys. Miss Twilly's waiting.
You know, gang, that Lionel may be rich, but his manners are mighty poor.
Yeah, mighty poor.
We'll give him a lesson he can really dig.
Oh, this is so exciting. Oh, I just love to dig up the past. Oh, unless it's mine.
You gotta work fast, guys. They'll be here any second.
Oh, what's in the bag, Spike?
See for yourself, Turkey.
Whoa! No! Where'd you get that?
Spike told me to pick it up at the joke shop. Looks real, don't it?
Yeah.
I can't wait until Miss Twilly sees that skull.
Yeah, one empty head meets another.
Haven't you slowpokes found anything yet?
A slowpokes might find something if you'd give us a hand.
Give you a hand? Certainly.
Eureka! I've discovered a relic.
May I see it?
Well, of course, my dear.
That's strange. It says made in Japan.
What, the made in Japan? Oh, my goodness. I had no idea that America was first settled by the Japanese.
You hear that, guys?
Who knows what we'll find today? Oh, I only wish we had the equipment for a heavier digging.
Miss Twilly, your wish is my command. This way, James. You may step down, James. I'll take over.
Bravo, Ronald. Show them how a man of action gets things done. Donald, what are you doing?
If that's how a man of action gets things done, we're in trouble.
Uh-oh. Looks like I'll have to dig up the thing. Thing ring, do your thing!
Don't worry, girls, I'll save you. Somehow.
One side, Sonny.
Oh, it's that marvelous hunk of hero, the Thing.
Hang on, girls. They'll soon be off of that pile of rocks through the courtesy of this pile of rocks.
Just when the things were getting interesting, an old rocket has to show up.
Boy, Mike, look at that.
Here, hold on to these.
It's not raining.
It'll be raining young goyles if we're not careful.
Oh, dear. They're going to rope a tightwalk. Oh, I walk the plank. Oh, I don't walk the tightrope. Oh, I can't bear to look.
Nice and easy, girls. Don't rock the rock.
Oh, the thing is so thrilling. Oh, but what a marvelous rescue.
If you ask me, he's just a show-off.
Nobody's asking.
Where is that dear boy, Benji?
Who knows? He's never where the action is.
I went to get this. It's a metal detector, in case we find some relics from the Iron Age.
Does it really work?
It sure does. Keeps going after one of my rings.
I'll put it in my purse.
Hey, there's something really strong activating this detector. Come on.
Wait, I forgot my purse.
Wow, look at this.
Ooh, I do believe it's an ancient ceremonial bracelet.
Is it worth any money?
Don't you ever think of anything but money?
Miss Twilly, that looks like an awful storm coming up. We better go.
Oh, yeah, you're right, my dear. Tomorrow we'll gather up all the dinosaur bones and assemble them at school. Come, students.
How about that bracelet Benji found? It might be worth a lot of bucks.
Here they go.
Okay, it's our turn to find all the loot. My metal detector's twice as strong as Benji's, so we ought to find twice as much stuff.
How does it work, Spike? Huh?
Here, hold it. You just turn this switch to on.
Like this?
Hey, come back with my detector!
Help!
Turn the power off, you dummy!
Oh, yeah.
Give me that. Now, if there's any metal around here, look out! Hit the dirt!
Hey! Look at that ring!
Oh, yeah! Maybe it's worth a lot of money.
Forget it, Turkey. This is gonna be my lucky ring.
Mike, look!
It's a twister!
Bad news! Let's get out of here!
We'll never outrace that tornado! There's a farmhouse up ahead! A run for the storm cellar.
Oh, you wait for me. Oh, I can't run like a teenager.
It's time for the thing to take on that big bag of wind. Just wait till I put my rings together. The thing's gonna twist you out of shape. Thing ring, do your thing. Oh, come on, thing ring. Please do your thing. I forgot. I gave one of my rings to Kelly. Whoa!
Operator, I've been cut off.
Okay, everyone. It's safe to come out now.
Benji, were you out here all this time?
No, I was there, and there, and there, and there. There may be more tornadoes on the way, so you'd better give me back my ring.
Ring? Oh, I forgot all about it. It's gone!
Gone?
I must have lost it at the dig site.
Oh, no.
Yes, Miss Twilly. We'll help you assemble the dinosaur bones later this afternoon. Miss Twilly says there's a tornado alert on the radio. We may be in for more twisters.
There's nothing I can do about it without my ring.
But we searched the area thoroughly. Maybe a wild animal picked it up.
This lucky ring sure is lucky. Nothing bad's happened to me since I found it at Banjo Cave today.
I've got to get my ring back, but I can't let him know how valuable it is. Hi, Spike.
Well, if it ain't my klutzy pal, Benji.
I don't know how to tell you this, Spike, but that new ring of yours is my old ring.
Are you saying that this ring is yours?
That's what I'm saying.
Well, we gotta follow the rules. And the rule is, find his keepers.
I gotta have that ring, Spike. You give it back to me or else.
Or else what?
That's a very good question. I'll be back as soon as I can think of an answer.
Well, where's the ring?
It's still on Spike's finger.
Don't worry. I just got a great idea.
Oh, boy! Fortune cookie!
Plenty for everyone. A special cookie for man with the lucky ring.
Hold it, hold it! Let the man with the lucky ring have a chance here. Tomorrow, Honorable Chopper will cover 100 miles without burning one single drop of gas.
Hey, Spike, that's great!
Yeah!
Keep reading, please. Why will Honorable Chopper cover 100 miles without burning one drop of gas?
Because Honorable Chopper will be on back of Honorable Tow Truck? Hey, how come I ain't so lucky anymore?
Maybe your ring is starting to bring you bad luck.
Maybe you're right. I better get rid of it.
Great. No, wait. Hey!
Kelly, look what's coming.
Oh, no. It's headed right for us.
Hey, Mr. Steamroller Man.
What do you want, kid?
Would you please back up for a second? Ring, ring, do your thing.
All right, you big blowhard. It's my turn.
You sure pack a wallop thing.
Yeah, maybe I should change my name to Rocky.
And with the help of your fellow students who found the bones of this prehistoric monster, I will now reveal a most unusual creature. A creature, I might add, that I assembled all by my very self. Oh, yeah.
That's right. We were too busy looking for your ring to help her.
I'm almost afraid to look.
Oh, it does look rather peculiar. But then they do say that two heads are better than one.
A is for apple. J is for jack.
Gentlemen, you may start your breakfast.
Apple is sweet, apple jacks. Cinnamon crunchy, fun to eat.
We wait for the secret weapon!
The thrills, the laughter, the music. Steven Spielberg presents a Don Bluth film.
Stick with me, okay?
An American Tale, rated G. Now at select theaters. Check newspapers.
When your parents didn't get you a Transformer, and your parents didn't get you a GoBot, they got you a Morphodroid. That's right, a Morphodroid. A remote control, because it had a wire, control car that turned into a robot. Basically just flipped up and it went, and it was a robot. Man. People give GoBots crap. Man, I still, to this day, have some cheesy Transformer and GoBot knockoffs. Maybe like Change-a-Bots and stuff like that. You know, the funny part about those is there was actually companies who just straight ripped off Transformers and GoBots. They didn't even change the mold. Some of them had the exact stickers and everything. They're still doing it this day. I remember being able to go to, you know, some stores and find the Constructicons or the Aerobots that were still formed, you know, Devastator and Superion. all knockoffs. But they were, you know, go back to the old school stuff. Because they, you did not get, you know, not every kid got Transformers. Not even every kid got a GoBot. Some kid got a Change-A-Bot. So, all right. Here we go. We're going back to another cartoon I have not showed in a long time, because there's only a handful of episodes available, and that is Pandamonium. Pandas were big in the 80s. Yeah, I mean, you'd always see them on the news. They were, you know, coming in from China, going to zoos all over the United States, being transferred from place to place. Poor panda bears. All they wanted to do was settle down in a bamboo forest, eat bamboo, and not have kids. See, that's what they get crap for, man. They were decided that they didn't need to bring any kids into this. And everybody's like, ah, these pandas got to have cubs. They're going to die off. Yeah. They were just like, yeah, we're good. But, and the funny part about it is, the studio behind Pandamonium, Marvel Studios. Marvel Studios pounded out a bunch of stuff back in the day. So, here you guys go. This is Pandamonium, 20,000 Laughs Under the Sea. Enjoy.
Mondragore, master of evil, steals the magical pyramid of power. Whoever has the pyramid controls the universe. But it falls and explodes in far-off Tibet, its pieces scattering all over the earth. Only an American boy sees the explosion. He and his sister fly there and meet three panda bears who help them fight Mondragore. From the skies, Mondragore controls wind, fire, thunder, and lightning. What on earth? His powers disappear, and he can only control the minds of others, and they carry out his evil plans. The race to recover the pieces of the pyramid is on. It's Pandamonium!
Peggy, your big brother is an experienced scuba diver. Well, I've been diving since I was 2 years old.
Yeah, I know. Only this isn't a bathtub and you're not diving for your rubber ducky.
That is nothing like soaking up the rays of the sun on a relaxing boat ride.
Ooh, I think I need some more suntan lotion. I'm getting a fur burn. Gosh, Chesty, you ought to be more careful brushing your teeth. You got toothpaste all over your face.
Brush your face, you toothpaste brain.
Come on, fellas. We got to get into the water and start looking for the next pyramid.
You heard him, guys. Yes, sir. Right away, sir. Hey, up, two, three, four. Up, two, three, four. About face.
First, fellas.
As soon as the pandas are ready, we'll dive in.
Hey, give me one of them flippers, Algernon.
You mean one of these?
Oh, so you want to play games, do you? What do you got to say about that, huh? Whoa!
You got the pyramid piece, Peggy?
Right here, Peter. Let's go!
Hey, where's Timothy?
Right here, Chesty.
What do you think you're doing in that crazy getup?
I'm afraid of fishes.
Oh, the little panda's afraid of fishies. Why, you fishhead, there ain't nothing out there bigger than a mini. See? Yay!
I'm not going in there. No way.
Oh, got just the way. Hey, up, two, three, four.
Well, gee, that was neat. Let me try. Hiya, hop, two, three. Wonder if that'd work on me. Hiya, hop.
Okay, you guys, keep a lookout for that pyramid piece.
Hey, I think I found it.
Be a star, Chesty.
Shut up and help get this thing off.
Oh, I'll have the little feller off before you can say...
Yo! That's my nose!
Shucks! You said it.
I'll do it myself. Hurts to double check. At least it usually never hurts. Oh!
Boy, lunchtime.
What are you doing, Bubblehead?
I'm having a peanut butter and jellyfish sandwich.
This ain't no time to be eating.
Wait, you forgot your peanut butter.
Yeah!
Cut the clowning, fellas. We've got to find the next pyramid piece before Mondragor can lay his clammy hands on it.
I won't have to lay my hands on it. I'll use the jaws of a shark. I command you, creature beneath the sea, bring the pyramid pieces.
Pyramid. Yeah, boy. Come to Algernon. Oh, isn't that cute? A little sharky. You didn't happen to see a pyramid, did you?
You idiot. That's a shark.
Yay! My man, Dolphin!
Don't let him get the pyramid!
Quick, pass me that pouch, Algernon.
Oh, I'll come on right up, Chesty.
There's something awfully fishy about this cave. Help! Get me out of here!
You can get him out. I don't want to go near anything with a mouth that be bigger than mine.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Algernon.
Algernon who?
Oh, boy. He would have to go and ask a tough question.
Just get me out of here.
Panda pouch.
In that case, I think we'd better sink the thing.
Oh, Mandragore's gone.
But he's still got the panda pouch.
Now to finish the job. The waves upon the sea I rule.
We still got a pyramid piece, Mondragor, and you'll never get it.
Indeed.
thing in the city of Atlantis.
You don't understand. We didn't crack your dome.
It was Mondragor. He...
Silence! Take them away!
Get off of me, you wet wimps.
He dragged around. Thank goodness.
Wonder where we are.
Big trouble, that's fair.
Climb up, you panda punk.
Speaking of clams, let's clam scram. Is he gone?
I think so.
Oh, isn't that cute? He's giving you a kiss.
Let's see how you like a clam kiss.
Oh, I think she loves me.
Come on, you flakes. We gotta find Peter and Peggy.
Wait, let us out. You're making a big mistake.
Oh, great. We survived Mondragor's whirlpool, only to be done in by a bunch of freaky fish people.
Peg, I think there may be a way out of here. There's no bars over here.
Peter, wait. It looks like those fish people put us in a tank. A people tank.
Come on, you guys. We gotta sneak through that fish-infested city and find Peter and Peggy.
Yuck!
I think they landed around here somewhere. Keep an eye out.
It just isn't safe out there for the panda.
Hey, look at that. A pistachio panda.
Great idea, Timmy. We'll disguise ourselves with that green goo.
Disgusting disguises are working like a charm.
I thought I'd find you three out here.
You are the three slime wrestlers I hired, aren't you?
Slime wrestlers? Why,
Come on, then. The crowd's waiting.
Ladies and gentlefish, the Atlantis Auditorium presents the greatest
beat me up?
Whoa, shucks. It's just a little good, clean fun. I guess it ain't that clean after all.
What's wrong with you three? You're not supposed to wrestle each other.
No? So who are we supposed to wrestle?
That. From the upper world! Get them!
Hi-ya! Whoa! Yee! Help!
Get them!
Thank you.
round it up soon, Your Highness.
Good. You know what to do with that. Great Lords of Neptune, another intruder from the other world. Seize him!
I am your master. Rise and obey. From this moment on, you'll do as I say. Take me to the tomb you've captured.
Yes, master.
I've just about got it, Peggy. Just a little more pressure on the tumblers and... I don't get it. It always worked on my bicycle lock.
Next time your bicycle's trapped, we'll give it a try.
Well, at least Mondragor won't ever get this pyramid piece.
I wouldn't count on it.
Mondragor!
Get the pyramid piece, then destroy it.
You'll never get this pyramid piece.
No, get rid of them.
Nice throw, Peter.
Quick, let's hide in there.
Oh, no. Gosh, we're awfully sorry.
Yeah, we didn't see him, Mondragor.
Mondragor!
Yeah! Get them!
Yes, ma'am. You heard her. Start picking them up. Up, up, up.
I'll take those.
Just take them. I didn't want them anyway.
Oh, no! Mondragor's going to get the pyramids.
Don't you worry, Peggy. They don't call me the pool parlor panda for nothing. Eight ball, I mean eight pyramid in the corner pocket.
Shot.
That's all of them. Let's ditch this place.
Don't let them get away.
Hurry. Into that submarine.
I hope you know how to operate one of these things.
Well,
Don't you worry. We'll take care of everything. Hiya.
Hold it, fella. I lost you back at the Yokoluk Gilligabikapoolumanukaloo.
Keep it up, fellas. Whatever you're doing, it's working.
They're getting away.
We can follow in our mini subs.
Whatever you say, Chesty.
Ow! Dial periscope! Dial periscope!
Okie dokie! You just rest, Chesty. I'll take a look.
Well, what did you see, Algernon?
Oh, nothing. Just a couple of giant eyeballs.
Giant eyeballs!
Something's got us.
And I've got a feeling it's something of Mondragor's.
What's the matter with him?
Oh, he's just trying to tell you there's a giant tentacle behind you, that's all.
Oh! Oh! Help! Get the
of me.
Oh, look at that. Looks like Peter Piper picked a pack of purple pandas.
We're out of control. Brace yourselves. In there.
Oh no! They're gone!
Looking for these?
Okay, guys, now!
Fire one! And a rotten one at that!
Give me the pyramid pieces, or you will be destroyed!
Not to mention us.
All right, guys, it's time for Papa Panda. All right, into the torpedo tube.
Wait a minute. I'm not a torpedo.
Oh, yeah? You are now.
I hope they know what they're doing.
I doubt it.
Our city.
Nah, it was nothing. We've saved continents, even entire planet.
You're welcome, Your Highness.
As a token of our appreciation, we have a little gift for you.
Peter, look! This thing's beeping like crazy!
I'll just put that little baby in my panda pouch.
Tom Gray, and I'll be right back with One to Grow On.
I'm glad you could come over, Beth. This dumb babysitting job has worn me to the max.
Yeah, but the baby is crying. Shouldn't you do something?
He's always crying. So what? Just put on some music. He'll stop in a while.
Oh, wait a minute here. Something's wrong. I mean, when you take on a babysitting job, you take on the responsibility that goes with it. Listen, if you have a job to do, you owe it to everyone, including yourself, to do it right.
Well, even if you don't care, I do.
What?
I'm glad you're not taking care of me.
Maybe she's right. I guess I better take this job more seriously. Hold on, I'm coming.
And that's One to Grow On.
An unusual thing happened recently. Some Cabbage Patch Kids were born with beautiful corn silk hair. Look, everyone said, you can wash and curl their hair and braid it and style it lots of ways. And they have their own brush they can hold. Seems as if they could have a different hairdo almost every day. And they always love to be loved. A lot.
Cabbage Patch Corn Silk Kids with everything you see here, each sold separately. Some accessories not included from Coleco.
What could be more terrifying than being Cop and Hot Rod stranded on an alien planet battling the merciless Sharktacons?
Wheelie, say, find friends today!
Transformers, for the meets the eye.
Meet the Sharktacons!
Autobots never face the evil force. Worse than the terror of the Sharktacons.
The Transformers, each sold separately from Hasbro.
Soaring through the galaxy of limbo on wings of silver and fighting with nerves of steel come the amazing Silverhawks.
Great sizzling stars.
They're going to get the jump on the intergalactic mob.
Tough luck, you space rats.
And give Monstar, public enemy number one, a taste of his own medicine.
Looks like our biggest hit yet.
So for out-of-this-world adventure, take off with your favorite new superheroes, the mighty Silverhawks.
Today at 3:30 on Channel 17.
Hey, hope you like Pandamonium. Like I said, this is all old school. There's no Guardians of the Galaxy, no Galaxy Rangers, no Cowboys, a Moo Mesa, none of that. All old school, 70s and 80s. So, I'm going to do that from every once in a while. I think I'm just going to do a theme episode, and that's what this one is, old school 80s. So, alright, here you guys go. I aired at the end of last week's episode. Going to find a few episodes, but this is Pac-Man, but season 2, episode 2. And this is when they started adding everybody, Super Pac and PJ and Baby Pac and stuff like that. I like Pac-Man. That was fun. I did. I just thought it was weird. It was this one sort of human guy, and he was the bad guy. He had the Darth Vader face. So, all right. This is Pac-Man Season 2, Episode 2. And this is Super Pac Bowl and Journey to the Pac Past. Enjoy.
Pac-Man.
This year's Super Pac Bowl is about to begin. Pack and Sack Packers will play the Power Pellet Pickers, led by their quarterback and our hometown boy, Pac-Man!
Yay! Yay, Packy! Google, mash him, Jana!
What we're after, the Pack and Sack Packers! Okay, men, prepare for Operation Ghost Gophers!
Aye, aye, Clyde! Hut, 2, 3, 4! Hut, 2, 3, 4!
Pac-Man's team will toss the coin to see who kicks off.
Call it, Pac-Man.
Heads! No, tails. No, heads. Tails.
Oh. It's heads.
Yeah! Ghost heads!
Uh-oh. I think I better scram before I get ghost blitzed.
Let's get him!
Oh dear, those awful ghost monsters are ruining the game!
Gaggle, get ghost stink!
Jump on, Vanessa Baron! Jump on, until they're gone!
Okay, I give up! You win! Don't chomp me!
Who wants to chomp you, Pac-Man?
Here, we're gonna chomp them!
So long, Pac Dummy.
We got him.
This is Clyde calling Mesmeron. Over.
Is this Mesmeron? Have you got the team?
We sure do. Ready when you are.
Attention, Pac fans. I, Mesmeron, have the Pack and Sack Packers. My ghost monsters will be taking their place and playing against Pac-Man's team. The winner of the game will take home the trophy and the location of the power forest, or you'll never see the Pack and Sack Packers again.
Ah, we've got nothing to worry about. I could beat those ghost monsters standing on my head.
The Ghostbusters are about to kick off.
Okay, team, let's cream those pack fiends.
Say, Clyde, I got a question.
What is it, Ghost Brains?
How am I supposed to kick the ball when I don't have any feet?
Do I have to think of everything?
Gee, thanks.
I got it!
Wrong, Pat-Punk! I got it!
That's a foul. Illegal use of the mouth, 15 yards.
Psst, Inky, you got that special football made of tar that Mesmeron gave us?
Sure! There it is!
Give me that. Here, swap this with the other football.
Look! An invisible butterfly!
I don't see any invisible butterfly.
Of course not! It's invisible, isn't it?
Hunt! Hunt! Hey, what are you doing in my hand? I just passed you! Hand off! Hunt!
Looks like Packy and his teammates really know how to stick together.
Touchdown!
No touchdown. Illegal use of a tar ball. 15 yards.
Order. Illegal use of the referee. 100 yards.
Way to go, Pinky! That's good for the extra point!
Oh, it's looking bad for the power pellet pickers as the Ghost Monsters go ahead 7-0.
No use, Pepper. With those ghostly cheaters and no referee, there's nothing in the world that can help us win.
Touchdown!
Oh, no, not him again. I think I'd rather lose the game and get chumped.
Have no fear. The one and only super splendiferous, all-powerful, not to mention good-looking, Super Pack is here. No applause, please. Thank you. Now, what sort of spine-tingling jeopardy can I get you out of today?
Well, how good are you at football?
Football? Why, I'm the greatest football player in the universe.
Oh, boy. What choice do I have?
Uh-oh! Pac-Man's got that super guy playing on his side.
Don't worry. I got some super tricks of my own. Let's see. Should I use the grenade ball or the helicopter ball? Ah, this guided propeller ball should fix that super fool.
Blast off!
What a kick! What a launch!
I got it!
And it's a reverse field goal for the Ghost Monsters!
Relax! Put those teeth away. I'm Super Pack, defender of the flea-bitten, fighter for truth, justice, and more dog bones. You wouldn't want to bite me now, would you? Oh, don't mind him. He's just one of my loyal fans. Shoo, stop that. Come on.
Oh, brother.
Come on, Pack Punks. Let's see how far you can kick it.
I'll kick this ball so far, they'll be running for a week to catch it.
They sure are sending up some weird-looking satellites these days.
Ah!
times 7. 18 times 6. 12 divided by 3.5. The square root of 11 plus 52 over x. Hi.
Hey, what are you waiting for? Wake up!
Yippee! Another teepee!
With 60 seconds left in the game, the Ghostbusters are leading 86-0.
There's only one chance. As much as I hate to suggest it, you've got to munch on one of your super-powered power pellets.
Lucky for you, I just happen to have one left.
I've got it, fellas!
Give me that!
Hi!
Whatever you do, keep that thing away from Super Pac!
30 seconds left in the game,
and the Ghost Monsters have the ball. The power pellet.
Get that pellet!
Hold it tight!
Dump it down!
Yeah, fight!
Wait a minute! The way to get my super-powered power pellet back is with my super mouth!
Ha ha! We got this game won now!
Yeah! That power forest will be ours any minute!
Okay, Ghost Thieves, I'll take that! A bit overripe, but otherwise not bad! Ready or not, here I come!
Super Pack Power!
Blow it!
Wait a minute, folks! Super Pack has the ball!
He's got a touchdown! And another! And another! And another!
And Super Pack played a perfect batting pass to buck the prize for Packy's power pellet pickers.
I can't stop!
Oh no! This chopper is jammed again!
Stop, you ghost chickens! Okay, I give up. You can have your pack and sack packers back. Anything, just stop that chomping maniac.
Oh my goodness, Packy, look. We've got to stop Super Pack before he chomps Packland into the Pack Canyon.
Quick, where's that super time warp space hole of his? There you are! Super Pack, over here!
Never fear! I'll repair the stadium!
Dougal, give me that!
Hurry! Close the hole! Oh, phew. Now I know why they call it the Super Pack Bowl!
I could have told you that. They named it after moi, the one and only super splendiferous, all-powerful, not to mention good-looking.
Pepper, have you seen my socks?
Chum Chum, would you take my socks?
okay, sorry I accused you. I can't find my socks. I've checked everywhere. The washing machine.
Who put them in there?
Nobody did. They got so tired of being dirty, they walked in by themselves.
Hardy har har. Oh, great. The washer ate my socks again.
I told you to call the repairman.
$30 an hour? Money doesn't grow on power pellet trees, you know. I'll fix it myself.
You were the one who fixed it the last time, Packy. That's why it ate your socks.
Oh, yeah? Well, this time I'll pull its teeth. That's not who I think it is it?
Hey!
I know, it's TJ.
How's it going, cuz? Just thought I'd drop in for the weekend and crash at your pad.
Oh, great.
Looks real bad, Dad. What you need is an expert pack mechanic.
Fixing a washer is no different than tuning a chopper. All you have to do is clean out the carbs, adjust the points, change the plugs. Voila! You're now the proud owner of a 400 cubic inch dual overhead cam fuel injected washing machine.
Yeah, but will it wash my socks?
It'll not only wash your socks, it'll do 0 to 60 in 9 seconds. Hey, careful! That's my last pair!
Hey, that sounds worse than before.
Relax, Pax. All we gotta do is adjust the muffler.
Whoa! No!
Packy! PJ! Where are you?
How did we get to the beach?
Hey, this isn't the beach, man. This is the Pakhara Desert.
Well, then, those must be the Pak Pyramids.
Whoa, they're really packed to the max.
Something tells me you turned my busted washing machine into a busted time machine.
I think you're right, Packy. I'd estimate the year to be about 2500 B.C.
B.C.?
Yeah, before chomping.
Bow down to the great pharaohs of Pakkardak. Oh, superior beings from the beyond, we are grateful that you have come to honor us.
Now these dudes know class when they see it.
We are ready for you, oh great Tutank Pac-Man.
Oh no, you don't understand. I'm not Tutank Pac-Man. I'm just playing Pac-Man. You see, my washing machine was on the fritz, and this fellow over here went and...
Silence! You do not have to explain. We know what you desire and are here to give it to you.
Oh, boy. You mean you got me a new pair of water skis?
No! We give you the Great Pack Pyramid, where you will be buried for eternity.
Just what I wanted. No, hold it, wait. I'm allergic to pyramids. I break out in mummy.
You must be properly dressed for your journey into the great beyond.
Hey, like what's wrong with my duds, dude?
Neck 32, waist 32, a chest 32. Hold this.
Hey, where'd everybody go?
Hang in there, Packy. I got a pack plan that'll get us out of here. Follow me.
Whatever you say, PJ.
Say, PJ. How are you gonna get us away from that pack pharaoh, anyhow?
Who are you?
Oh!
Hey, this is one funky little chopper! Hi-o, PJ! Away!
Don't just stand there! Our mummy is getting away!
Hey, it's PJ all the way!
Hurry, PJ, get that washing machine going.
I don't think I can, Packy.
Why not?
We're out of soap.
Don't let them get away! I got him!
Maybe, but where are we now?
You'll be on me ship, and you'll regret it.
You'll regret it!
Oh no, it's Packbeard the Pirate!
Aye, that's right, and I'll show ye what I do to buccaneers what come upon me ship without asking.
Show them!
Now, start walking.
Oh no, wait! I'm allergic to sharks. I break out in teeth marks.
Too bad, Packbeard. I guess you'll never find the treasure now.
Treasure? Tell me where it is.
Tell him, Packy.
Me? I don't know if there's any treasure.
So you ain't talking, eh?
Oh, no. Oh, why, of course I'm talking. It's buried on that island.
Hardy, hard.
We'll soon be rich, me little pot parrot.
Soon be rich.
Land ho!
Land ho!
Will you shut up now? Show me where the treasure be.
Now that I think about it, maybe it was a different island.
If it's not buried on this island, you're gonna be.
I think you buried it in that mine shaft. Remember, Packy?
I did? I did. Yeah, sure. Of course I did. Didn't I?
No, go in there and get it. Well?
I'm looking.
He's looking.
Shut up. It's an earthquake!
No! It's not an earthquake!
It's a whale!
Abandon whale!
Abandon whale!
I'm heading for shore!
Wait for me!
We made it!
Not yet! Quick, start her up! Get us out of here!
Don't worry, cuz, we got plenty of time!
Oh no, we don't! Where are we this time?
I don't know, but if my pack history serves me, that looks a lot like Wilbur and Orville Pack.
I'm telling you, Orville, the propeller goes on the bottom.
You're wrong, Wilbur. It goes on the wheel like this. At the rate you dudes are going, you'll never get that thing to fly.
Fly? This thing ain't supposed to fly.
That's right. We're trying to invent the lawnmower.
Come on, Packy, we gotta help these guys out so I don't have to restudy my history when we get home.
I don't know if that's such a good idea, PJ.
You guys may not know it, but you're about to invent the airplane.
Air what?
Ah, this baby'll do Mach 3 now.
I don't know. Still looks like a lawnmower to me.
Come on, Packy, let's take it for a little spin.
Not me. If Pac-Man were meant to fly, they'd have wings.
You got wings now!
Say, Orville, I wonder how they're gonna cut the grass from up there.
Say! You fly pretty good, PJ.
Oh, no. What happened?
Nothing much. I guess they forgot to invent jet fuel.
Oh, I think we're going to invent the plane crash.
Cool it, man. I got everything under control. It's a good thing I used your old washing machine to power this jet.
Come on, Orville. Let's go invent the video game.
Oh!
Now, I wonder where Packy and PJ could be, Pack Baby.
Dadu! Hi, Dada! Hi, PJ!
Oh, boy! Oh, what a trip!
Yeah, I dug it too, cuz. Oh, gee, I got my sweater dirty. Guess I better wash it.
Oh, no! No!
When they get back, Pack Baby, remind me to have PJ fix the TV for me.
The Force is back. The Rebels won't tire till they see the last of the Empire. And Kenner's there with Star Wars Return of the Jedi collection.
Blacker Scout reports. All's quiet at the security shield.
That shield and guard's gotta go. I'll cause the diversion.
Han Solo, Low Gray, Chief Sherpa, and Biker Scout each sold separately.
Yaha!
Why, you little Ewok.
Let the rock roll.
You're a kid.
Han Solo, Chief Chirper, Biker Scout, and Lowbray action figures each sold separately from Kenner's Star Wars Return of the Jedi collection.
At last, I've got He-Man trapped with my walls of evil.
Oh, yeah? Bastrosaurus bashes evil away!
Skeletor He-Man figures and Bastrosaurus vehicle each sold separately.
Bash away!
Bastrosaurus, Bastrosaurus.
Next bash is on you, Foamface.
Bastrosaurus, new from the Masters of the Universe collection. Not for use with some figures, each toy sold separately. From Mattel.
Hey. How many people did the Olympic prize thing? That thing, right there. Boom, this. That's right. I keep staring over at my monitor. Get the free stuff. I want to know if anybody ever did this, because if you did, let me know what this is about, because I had no clue when I was a kid. I still have no clue when I'm an adult. I probably could look it up on the internet, but I guess it's not that important to me. But you needed to learn karate. You needed to learn judo, jiu-jitsu. Yeah, you could learn it through a comic book. So at least that one ain't Count Dante, which is such a great, great, great rabbit hole to go down. You ever get a chance, start looking up all the Count Dante stuff. That's craziness. Alright. I hope you guys liked Pac-Man, because here we go. I've aired this episode before, because there's only a handful left. But people have asked me for this cartoon. And I think it's about time, because it's been... I bet it's been 10, 11 months since I aired it. And that is Turbo Teen. I know you've asked for it. Here you go, Turbo Teen. I was digging through the other day, and I found another episode, but it's German with English subtitles. So if you guys don't mind German with English subtitles, let me know, because I will air that episode. So just message, you know, comment, whatever, let me know, please. It's the only one I've not aired, and like I said, I found one with German dialogue and English subtitles, so we'll see what we can do. But this is Daredevil Run. Enjoy.
I'm Brett Mather. Stormy night, when a bolt of lightning forced me off the road, my car skidded into a government laboratory where a top-secret experiment was underway. I swerved into the path of Dr. Chase's molecular transfer ray, causing me and my car to become one. The incredible Turbo Team!
Daredevil Run? That's a cross-country race. From here to New York.
There's Caldwell.
We better make this fast. The race is about to start.
Then we are in the Daredevil Run.
But we're not ready. TT needs a tuna. Oil.
Lou.
I'd like you to meet your passenger, Paula.
Hi.
Of course, there's nothing a super mechanic such as myself can't handle in a jiffy.
Paula is a government witness. She must be in New York by Thursday to testify against the Dragon.
The Dragon? The international jewel thief?
Paula can put him away for good, but the Dragon has vowed to keep her out of the courtroom. He's got his men watching every airport, train station, and bus depot in town.
So the Daredevil Run is a cover.
It's a route the Dragon won't suspect.
Take your positions.
I'm counting on you. We'll meet in New York.
I really can't thank you guys enough.
No big deal. We put our lives on the line for people in need every day.
Oh, brother.
Leaving, but the girl's not with him. What?
tried. But Caldwell didn't pull it off. The girl's in the race. Get her!
Arizona already? We're making great time!
The dragon was right. She's in a red car.
Nothing really. Built it myself from the struts on up. Hey,
lock it off. Alex, look out!
Yeah, keep your eye on the road, Alex.
Who was that?
Paula, I'd like you to meet my computerized car, Turbo Team.
The pleasure's mine.
Nice to meet you, too.
Ouch! Somebody really wants to win this race.
Uh-oh. I'm losing it.
Overzealous racer.
Let's see if you'd lose that bet.
That's the sign of the dragon. He's on to me. Wow, that was some driving, Alex.
You're looking at a dude who's got it under control.
I think the car deserves a little credit too, Alex.
No sign of them. Up ahead, I think I see something.
This ought to flip them out, huh, Alex?
What's he doing? Whoa!
Nailed them, Turbo Teen!
Yeah, well, we're still a long way from New York.
You should have seen it. The car, it was unbelievable.
Trade! Don't give me excuses! Give me the girl!
You're some driver, Alex. We're right back with the leaders.
Well, some people have said I'm the next Mario Andretti.
Alex?
Of course, behind every great driver, there's a great car.
Hey, what about me?
Well, we'll see if we can scrounge up a couple of quarts of oil.
Great. Oh, no, the dragon's men! If they see me, we're through!
I got you! I got you!
I hope they return the favor.
Hey! That car squirted me! Wow!
It's a little trick I learned in auto shop.
What we need is a plan. Some way to nail the dragon before he gets to you.
And we better come up with it fast. The dragon's men are outside.
Brett! Paula, this is our friend Brett.
Caldwell thought you might need my help. Hurry, they're coming!
I don't see them. Maybe they went out back.
We're taking our lunch to go.
That was close. They almost got Paula.
What if we gave them Paula? Then we could follow them to the dragon's hideout.
No way. No way. Too dangerous. I'd risk myself first.
Oh, I'm glad you feel that way, Alex.
Hmm?
Nothing like a hot day to get us back in the race. Realism? All set here.
Not bad. I think he's ready.
Do I have to wear lipstick?
If you want the dragon to believe you're Paula.
Too bad Brett couldn't stay to see this.
Oh, I think he gets the picture.
The tracking device is in the comb, Alex.
Hurry, here they come.
Good luck, and thanks.
Help me. My car! It's stuck!
There's the girl. Where are the others?
Must have gone for help.
Oh, no! Not you! Oh! Help! Put me down, you brutes!
Sister, you got a date with the dragon.
Like a charm. How's the tracking device?
Loud and clear. Let's follow.
Wake up, Paula. They seem to be slowing.
Gee, I must have dozed off. We're in Iowa already?
We've got them. They must be arriving at the dragon's lair. What's up, Rusty?
Dark Rider!
What's he doing here?
Do something, Turbo Teen!
Get out! There's one chance! Turbo Thrust, don't fail me now!
He's coming back, Turbo!
Who'd expect Dark Rider to give up easily? A pitchfork? That's worth a try. Who can plant this Dark Rider? Someday I'm gonna catch that guy.
We're getting closer, Turbo. Dark Rider dropped his makeup kit.
Well, right now, nothing's gonna stop us from following Alex to the dragon. Ray, I had to say something. It's getting cold!
Brett! Where's Turbo Teen?
Turbo Teen? I sent him to get gas.
Wow, what a car!
Without your tracking device, how will we find Alex?
I remember the coordinates, but we're gonna have to walk as long as it keeps raining.
You won't get away with this! You and the dragon are going to jail!
Is that so?
That's right! I'm gonna put you away, you rotten crook!
I doubt it.
My hairdresser's gonna hear about this.
A setup. Well, when his friends come for him, we'll be waiting.
Alex is in danger, and it's all because of me.
Don't give up yet, Paula.
The train station. That's gotta be where the dragon's holding out.
Wig!
Then the dragon's onto him. They must be on the train. Go!
We've got company.
Care for some chow?
Yeah, something nice and hot.
Come on, Paula. Let's check the train for the dragon and Alex.
Just beans, but they'll warm you up.
I wish there was another way. Yuck! I hope they're hot enough. Oh, it's working!
The dragon. I think they're alone. Good. I've got a plan. Room service.
Come in. I don't remember ordering anything.
It's a surprise.
When you need it.
That's your service, Alex.
They're all yours, Turbo Teen.
I told you about that car. Run!
Can't follow us up here.
Be a tunnel. Here goes nothing. Okay, gang, it's New York or bust. You'll have to jump.
If the girl gets to the trial, I'm finished. We've got to beat them to New York.
All of this will have to be our little secret. I going to change to Turbo Team? Beauty Pop. Come on, Brett.
High heat coming up.
Just getting a perm. He's heading over the river! This is gonna take perfect timing! Gotcha!
A car can't do that!
Well, it did! Shake him off!
Now that's a car with guts!
And he needs our help! Come on! The grappling hook!
T.T.
All right, it's hooked onto my axle. I'll just reel us in.
It's working.
He's pulling us down.
There's nothing I can do.
We can handle the dragon from here, but you only have 5 minutes to get Paula to court.
Doesn't the guy ever say thanks?
Still got a minute before the trial starts.
Look, a car!
Order in the court.
Here you go, Paula. Coast-to-coast delivery.
You guys have been terrific. I don't know what to say.
Say you'll meet me after the trial for some pizza.
You're on.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Yes, Your Honor.
Well, maybe not the whole truth.
In the news, locked out on the St. Lawrence. The main water highway from the Great Lakes to the Atlantic Ocean is blocked off by a breakdown in a lock, a big elevator for ships. We'll be back with the St. Lawrence Seaway in the news. And now, a roadblock on a highway for ships in the news. The St. Lawrence Seaway connects the Great Lakes with the Atlantic Ocean, letting ships carry such cargoes as grain and iron ore from the Midwest to the rest of the world. Between the ocean and Lake Erie, the water level rises nearly 600 feet. To make that climb, especially around Niagara Falls, ships pass through locks, giant ship elevators. A ship going upstream enters a nearly empty lock. The doors are closed and water is let in to raise the ship to the level of the water beyond the lock. Normally, this is the busiest time of year on the St. Lawrence Seaway because by mid-December, heavy ice on the St. Lawrence River will close the passage to most ships. But the seaway is closed right now, not by ice, but by a crumbling concrete wall that temporarily trapped a ship in lock number 7 on the Welland Canal around Niagara Falls. Repair work is underway, but meanwhile, Great Lakes shipping is at a standstill, getting backed up as ships approach the canal and have nothing to do but wait. The lock breakdown is affecting shipping and the jobs that depend on it as far west as Chicago, Illinois, and even Duluth, Minnesota, halfway across the continent at the western end of the water highway from the Atlantic. Officials have now cleared the damaged lock and hope to have the seaway open to traffic again by next week. I'm Christopher Glenn with a traffic jam on the St. Lawrence Seaway in the news.
Wow. All this work's making me really hungry.
McDonald's introduces Super Summer Sizes.
Laughs around the pool make me so thirsty.
Larger than large mega servings of icy Coca-Cola, golden fries, and thick milkshakes, but for a limited time only. So drive through today.
Serving up summertime at McDonald's.
Milk kick.
favorite health kick milk.
Hey, who remembers 48 years ago when the Defenders fought the Brotherhood of Evil Mutants? I know this never happens nowadays. You never have X-Men villains fighting the Avengers anymore. But, you know, you had that at one point here. Wow. Boom. There they are. All right. I hope you guys like Turbo Team. Like I said, I've only got a handful of episodes. Let me know if you want me to run the one in German with English subtitles. So it's probably the only way I won't be able to show that episode. So if you don't want to watch it, I think it'd be weird to show a whole one in German unless people like were okay with it. So let me know. All right. Here's a cartoon I forgot till relatively recently. I was reading an old comic, and I don't have the comic in front of me. But Jana of the Jungle. Man, I forgot about this until I seen an ad with the Fantastic Four and Godzilla and Yogi Bear's Space Adventures. Forgot about this one because they did a lot of those back in the day, man. The Tarzan-esque stuff. It wasn't Tarzan. So, Jana come from DC Comics, I believe. But this is the first episode. Jana, episode one. The Golden Idol of Korgas. Korgas? Korgas. So, enjoy.
Are you certain this Jana you've told us about will be able to help Dr. Cooper?
Nobody knows the jungle better than Jana, Mrs. Hennin. If she can't help you, nobody can.
Yes, Pico, I've got something for you.
Jana, it is Ben Cooper.
Ben, we'll meet him at the clearing.
I guess we owe our lives to you.
She saved me more than once.
It's good to see you, Ben.
Jana, I'd like you to meet James Hennin and his wife, Lee. This is Jana and her friends Montaro, Tico, and Ghost.
A white jaguar.
It's a pleasure.
They need your help, Jana.
And while we were exploring deep in the interior, our son was captured by a tribe known as the Gorgas.
The Gorgas? But they live far upriver in the forbidden jungle.
Even I've never been to that part of the jungle. Gorgas hate intruders going into their territory. They deal harshly with strangers.
But you're our only hope.
Oh! What was that?
Tico, give that back. You'll have to forgive Tico. He collects things. Your earring is beautiful, Mrs. Hennin. Gold, isn't it?
Yes. Gold is sort of our, hobby.
The Hennins have rented a boat to take them upriver. They'd like you and Montaro to go, too.
If you'll agree to help us, Jana.
Montaro?
The forbidden jungle of the Gorgas. It is dangerous, but even more so for a child. We must help.
Thank you.
When do we start?
First thing in the morning.
We've got supplies to last 5 days if necessary.
Ghost! Ghost! Hello! 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 Hello!
are. We almost sailed without you. Now, Chico, you know Ghost is always grouchy when he first wakes up.
Take care of yourself, Jana.
Understand those Gorgas have a thing about gold.
A thing?
You know, jewelry, plates, golden idols.
Culture Soto, the sun god of the Gorgas.
Yes, that's him, Culture Soto. And he's made of solid gold, right?
So the legends say. I have not seen it for myself.
You must be terribly worried, Mrs. Hennen.
Worried?
About your son.
Oh, yes. Yes. Talking to that bird?
Montaro! Pichu tells us there are rapids ahead!
We'll be overturned!
What are you saying?
I'm asking Pichu for help.
How can a bird help us?
He can guide us through the rapids.
Of the jungle raised Jana from a child. They are her family.
We made it.
That was quite an experience. How much farther before we dock?
We've still got a distance to go. Some of the most dangerous sections of the river.
Around this bend lies one of them.
Look, up ahead, James.
The trees are so dense, they're blocking out the sunlight.
We must get through this place quickly. It is where many piranha breed.
Piranha? Those tiny little fish that can eat a man in seconds?
It's all right, Chico. We'll be through this section in a few minutes.
This whole place gives me the creeps. James, what happened to the motor?
It cut out. And from the looks of it, it's going to take some time to fix it.
It is too dangerous to remain here. I will push us over to the bank.
I can't believe how fast they went through that thing.
Montaro, there's a vine up ahead. If I can just get to it, I can get to shore and then pull the boat in.
It is too far. You cannot swim in these piranha waters.
But you can flip me through the air.
You don't actually mean you're going to try something like that.
It's the only chance we have. Montaro?
Ready. Go! Make it, Chico. She will make it.
Just a little more. Easy now.
Jana!
I'm all right.
I think I found out what's wrong. I ought to have it in about an hour.
We are nearing the forbidden jungle now, and there is the city of Gorgas.
James, that's it.
Montaro, we can pull the boat in over there.
The jungle holds many dangers.
Don't be frightened,
Tico. We'll protect you.
We will approach the city from the jungle side.
James, look! It's a puma!
Ghost?
Puma is trapped, Jana.
Quicksand.
What luck! Now, let's get out of here!
We can't leave him to die.
What are you going to do with a necklace?
It's a special necklace, Mrs. Hennen, given to me by my father many years ago. Thanks, Ghost.
The spine will help us.
But I don't understand. Why are you rescuing a dangerous cat?
It's a living thing, Mr. Hennen. It has the right of every creature on the earth to life.
That's incredible.
We must go.
Montaro's right. We must rescue your son and be out of this jungle before nightfall. Move carefully now. It's a long drop.
We are near the plateau.
Will you look at that?
The city of Gorgas. It's beautiful.
It certainly is beautiful.
It will be too dangerous for us all to go into the village. Montaro and I will go first and try to locate your son. Wait here.
Do you think they suspect?
Not a chance. We're home free.
What was that you said Gorgas did with intruders?
You do not want to know.
No. Quiet, Tico. It'll be all right once we explain.
It is wise you calm your great white cat. We do not wish to harm such a splendid animal.
But we wish you no harm. Take us to your chief. We will tell him what brings us to your city.
You have come here for the same reason others have come. You will never leave. Come!
What a lucky break for us. Now they won't be able to interfere.
But we have come on a peaceful mission, great chief of the Gorgas.
That is the truth, Chief Caro. We are looking for a little boy who was lost in your territory.
You lie! We have seen no little boy. You have come to steal Kochusoto, like the others.
It is their sacred sun god, pure gold.
We will deal with you later, after we have got your accomplices.
It is the Hennens. It is they who tricked us. There is no lost son.
We must return Kochusoto to his resting place. Quickly, after them. Hurry! They will not get away.
Montaro, now's our chance.
The door is locked. We cannot escape.
You forget. Tico is very good at unlocking doors. Hurry, Tico. Open the door.
Well, Tico?
He's done it. Let's go.
coming after us any minute.
Just be careful you don't drop that gold statue.
Don't worry. We're not letting go of this until somebody puts sacks of money in our hands.
Hurry, James, before they get here.
We did it, and we're going to be rich.
Yes, now that we've found our little son, thanks to Jana and her friends.
I haven't forgotten, Tico.
Jana, the head ends ran this way.
We can't leave ghosts behind.
Yes, Ghost, and you'll be free, too. Pull, Montaro. Now we go after those thieves. No, Ghost. Quick, back the way we came.
Fools, we could have brought their sun god back to them.
But we didn't know they were after Coach Osolto. You've got to believe us.
I listen to your lies no longer. After my men bring your friends back, you will all pay for your treachery.
But your men will never catch them.
The boat is too swift for your men.
Cocho Salto will return, even though our sacred sun god unleashes his powerful weapon.
To make it ashore.
You see? Cocho Soto will soon return to us. Hey-ya!
Water devils touch our great chief!
Stop! You might hit the chief!
Take her away!
I can save him!
Fast! What?
Oh!
going to be rich, are we?
Will you? Oh, no! It's coming right for us!
Ghost for both of us.
Not even in the ancient legends of our people has one performed such a daring feat as Jana of the Jungle. She has saved the life of your chief and helped us recover our sacred sun god, Cochosolto.
Thank you, Chief Kato, and your people. And I promise you, those who tried to steal Cochosolto will be turned over to the law to pay for their crime.
You and Montaro and your good friends will always be welcome in the Forbidden Jungle. You are forever a friend of the Gorgas.
This is a Cajun Spice Ruffles potato chip. Now, some people might think it's too hot. No, it's not too hot. It's spicy, yeah. Now it's hot, I guarantee. Mmm.
Cajun Spice Ruffles brand potato chips.
Mama thinks it's special. How do I know? 'Cause my Skippy tells me so.
Of all the national brands, only Skippy has both high protein and less sugar.
Grandma Mama put Skippy in orange.
Skippy for good nutrition.
This place is crawling with biker scouts.
Don't worry, they don't mess for us Ewoks.
From Kenner's Star Wars Return of the Jedi collection, new Wicked Warwick and Princess Nisa each sold separately.
Quiet, Nisa, here comes a biker scout.
Ayala! Let's go, Yibanga!
He's gaining on us.
Aye!
Head for the forest.
Close call.
Yup, yup.
New Wicked Warwick and Princess Nisa each sold separately from Kenner's Star Wars Return of the Jedi collection.
Return of the Jedi. When you make friends with an Ewok, you're making the best friend in the universe. He'll help you through the bad times and lead you to the good. There's Wicked Warwick, bravest of all the Ewoks, and Princess Nisa, the cuddliest in the Empire. But make sure they're not caught off guard. Who knows when the evil Empire will return? Only you can decide with Star Wars toys.
Hey man, nothing's in the 70s like a gold medallion. You could get your Hulk and Spider-Man medallions, man. You know, have your leisure suit on and your pimped out medallion. So, alright. I'm going to go ahead, let you guys go. I'm going to try to put an episode here at the end. Also, you can find the captain at these local comic book conventions if you're in Ohio. Jim and Dan Comic Con, or Jim and Dan Comic Book Show, located at the Wright State Student Union Center in Dayton, Ohio, June 12th. I'll be there 10 to 4 p.m., 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. I'll be set up there as RU Game. You can come visit me, say hi, tell me you like the show, tell me you hate the show. Just let me know. Come and buy cool stuff off me. Get comic books, toys, video games, whatever I happen to have that day. And then the return of Pickle Comic Con, June 26th, located at the Miami Valley Center Mall in Pickle, Ohio, off Route 36, Ash Street. Because it's 36 and Ash Street are the same street. Located in the old Elder Beerman's building, My guest list is ever expanding. You can check that out at Pickle Comic Con on Facebook. And it's P-I-Q-U-A, for those people who don't know how to spell Pickle. Because that is a weird, weird name. I always love people when they're like, we're from Piqua. So, you can find the captain at Pickle Comic Con. I will be there 10 to 4, selling comic books, toys, you name it. Lots of vendors will be there. List is ever growing, almost daily. And we will be doing it again, hopefully in November. But I'm going to bid you adieu and tell you again, you watch us every Monday at 12 noon Eastern Standard Time for the Group Therapy TV podcast. Every Friday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for Sci Fridays. And of course, you're watching Saturday Morning Serials, and it drops every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. You come to my shop. You find me on Facebook. You find me, find us at Are You Game on Facebook. You can find Pickle Comic Con on Facebook. You can find me on Twitter. I am listed as Captain Cartoon. And I'm still looking for a name. I got people. This is Saturday Morning Serials. The SMS Nation. The Animation Nation. Somebody put the Serial Killers. I like that, but that's, I don't know. That's a little dark. And, So, as I've said once, I'll say it again. Just because you grow older doesn't mean you have to grow up. There's always time for cartoons. And I will see you next time for more Saturday Morning Serials. So take care, everybody. See ya. And hopefully there's a cartoon after this. So I'm going to try. And, hope you like the cartoon, because this one's not 80s, it's 90s, so.